Hi, and welcome to the Crystal Clear Show. Today we're going to speak about various things, but first of all we have an obvious problem. Jasper is not here at the moment. I don't know where he is.
I'm here.
Where is he?
Where?
What the hell?
Don't worry, man. It's all good.
Whew, shit. You okay?
Yeah, I'm okay, man.
I'm
just coming from carnival.
All right, okay. How was it?
It's good. This is for later.
Okay, nice.
Okay.
Okay. So I was just basically presenting the show. And what are we going to talk about today?
Oh, yeah. Perfect. First of all, we should introduce again our douchebag jar here. The douchebag jar, we brought it in to today's show because some people of our audience said we use too many swear words. So they were telling us to find a way so we use more diverse and very different vocabularies and not to use so many bad words. So we said that we will put money in, €1, for every time we say something which we're not supposed to say.
Hey, but one thing, I agree about no swearing and everything,
yes.
But it's not only me. I mean, you always say fantastic, amazing,
okay.
Awesome.
Okay.
So when you say fantastic, amazing, awesome, or check it out, you cash it in.
Okay, I'll cash
anyway,
it in.
Today.
Yes, so Valentine's Day is coming up, and we talked to a few people from our university what they think about Valentine's Day. And it was quite interesting to find out what they actually think about it, how they not like it, how some people, some couples really enjoy it, and for other people, how it's just a way to eat some chocolate, just an excuse. So,
what's your point of view?
My point of view, I think it's not necessary. Such a day is not important.
Interesting.
Yeah.
So we basically went around our university, and we made a little interview. And check it. Look at it.
You almost said it.
Yo! Welcome to the Crystal Clear Show.
Okay, hi. Thank you. Welcome to the Crystal Clear Show. Thank you very much. First of all, I think, Jasper, you have a question for both of these young men.
Yes, as you all know, Valentine's Day is coming up and we are wondering what people think about Valentine's Day. So are you excited to answer some questions for Valentine's Day?
I am very, very excited to answer some questions for Valentine's Day.
Chiara, come back! We have some questions!
No, please, I beg you.
Dude, why are you doing this to me?
So what do you think of Valentine's Day?
I actually think it sucks.
No, I don't give a shit.
You don't care about Valentine's Day?
No.
The whole like company thing just to make you sell like chocolates and eat chocolates and stuff.
I think it's a marketing gag.
Yeah, and it's very stereotypical. Like what men are supposed to buy women stuff. That is so sexist.
I think it's a great fiesta time.
I can't wait. Got my hormones, you know, pumping around here. I feel like a machine, man.
Why don't we have Louis?
I love romantic movies, romantic dinners, chocolate.
So consider yourself romantic soul. Yes.
Some rose leaves on the bed. Yeah, I'm a romantic person. My number is 0.
What are your plans for St. Valentine's?
Well, it's going to be a very hot date.
Do you have a girlfriend?
Yes.
And what are your plans for Valentine's Day with her?
I really don't know.
Very
exciting. It will.
I don't expect anything because I'm just too romantic to expect anything.
Maybe dinner. And then let's see what happens.
That's it.
I want the guy to wait for me to get him something because that is the turnover, people. This is a revolution, okay? Women should like revolt against this. What are we supposed to like wait for a gift and then what if they don't give us
thank
a gift?
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Man, no, I'm still saying some stuff, okay? Why are we supposed to wait for a gift and then we don't even like it and so we're supposed to feel bad about it? We choose the gift and we make it.
Do you have a girlfriend or would you like to advertise yourself to a camera?
No, I'm good to go. Thank you. I am currently looking for a reproductive mate. Okay. My phone number would
female?
Be plus. Female, yes, of course. My number would be plus 34 668-7854.
How about you?
Hi guys.
I'm actually a very shy person, and yeah, I would be looking for someone that would be gladly selling one of these fine university ladies right here. So yeah. Yeah, for sure, please help me.
Anyone,
me I'm desperate.
Your name?
Clara.
Your age?
19.
Hair color?
Brown eyes, 1.70 meters.
Anyone, any girl you have in your, like, you particularly want to see for Valentine's Day? You can't declare yourself in front of her now.
Mom, I love you. I love you a lot, seriously.
Okay.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much, everybody. This goes up to all my homies in the West.
Yeah, and to mine in the East, and for you to know, that was just some insights of our East students and students in general, what they are planning for Valentine's Day, what they think about Valentine's Day, what they're going to do on Valentine's Day. And it's...
Thank you.
Thank you.
So welcome back. So that was quite interesting. By the way, we'd just like to mention that the Crystal Clear Show will not take any death threats for granted by Louis V, who said if we put him on, he will kill us. Sorry, Louis V, you know who you are. We had to. Moving on, don't forget, Valentine's Day is tomorrow, so do something.
Yeah, it surprise your girlfriend or not, or start an anti-Valentine's Day party with the sole purpose of getting drunk and having good times.
Exactly. Something, a little announcement, which could be a little, but it is pretty big. Friday, there are auditions at our university for the
IE Awards.
IE Awards and talent show. So, Friday afternoon, come and do the auditions. Maybe you're a good singer. You can juggle pretty
well. Maybe
you
have a special talent. You're a good singer or
anything.
You can.
I think you're a pretty good juggle. You can do that.
Yeah, maybe I should do that. Yeah. Why not?
So, Friday afternoon and next week, the IE Awards.
Which will be very interesting.
Yes, very.
Also, Carnival.
Carnival.
Oh, is that today why you came is like that? Wednesday, the last day of Carnival. And we had a very, very great time. I have to be careful that I don't use words that
use.
Great time. The last past week, there was a lot of things going on in Germany, in Brazil, with the big Carnival in Rio. So it's definitely people enjoyed the time very much.
Yeah.
We're gonna have some guest speakers today at our show who visited the Carnival in Cologne, Germany, and they have some quite interesting stories to tell, I'm sure. So that's something we're looking forward to later. Elliot, not to mention, what do you have a bad boy cap there?
Yeah, it was pretty bad. You know what I mean?
Okay.
Anyway,
let's just welcome our guests.
Yes, our guest who will be. Their names.
Oh.
Anyway. Yes.
Oh, their name. Well, there's Viktor, Leopold, and Moritz. They still have to decide who is going to talk, because. They're not sure what to sell. Some people can't really remember what happened on Carnival.
We won't ask why they don't remember.
We won't go into that. They will keep their stories for themselves.
Yes.
But we're just gonna ask how it was, what Carnival is all about, and those simple questions.
So now is the interview with these three German members. Okay, so...
Yeah, welcome. We're here with Julian and Viktor, who just came back from Carnival. My first question to you is, how was Carnival?
Carnival is amazing. You can't describe it with words. Every time I go back to Germany or to Krefeld or to Cologne for Carnival, it's amazing. It's comparable to Mallorca a bit.
Guys?
Mallorca.
Yeah. Guys.
Wait. Guys is a word where you have to pay on the douchebag jar. You use it way too often.
Fuck.
Hey, and no swearing, man.
Shit.
No.
Oh.
No pain.
Okay, sorry.
Okay. Next show we increase it to 2 euros for swear words.
Okay, sorry.
Sorry. It's like Mallorca, you said. How? Why is it, how is it like Mallorca?
Yeah, it is all about partying. It's all about dancing, being in a good mood, and well, a little bit slightly about drinking.
A little bit about drinking. Okay, and you're obviously dressed up. Victor, what are you wearing?
Yeah, what the hell is that?
I'm the official carnival Christmas tree.
Oh.
Yeah, and I
can
got
you sit,
there's
can
an
you
official
stand up,
carnival
maybe?
Christmas tree?
Like, yeah.
Wow, look at
it's
this.
It's me. Since this year, there's an official carnival Christmas tree.
It's very
you look
pretty.
Very cute in this.
Yeah, and I can dance.
I don't know. I don't know anything about carnival. I don't know anything about carnival, but when you dress up like that, do you like get with, I mean, do you flirt with other opposite sex, or like this is like
chance. Well, everybody's dressed up. Some people dress up so they're not recognized for who they actually are. Some people have the face to, you know, be dressed up normal. And yeah, but it's fun because everybody gets dressed up. Everybody's in a good mood. You get to meet new people. I met quite a lot of Asians who thought it's funny to take pictures with the Christmas tree in front of the Cologne Dome. But yeah.
Cool. So how long is Carnival actually?
It starts on Thursday, which is called Altweiber in German, and it ends with the Monday, which is called Rosenmontag.
What is this Wednesday we're having today? Is it Asher Wednesday? What is this?
Yeah, Asher Mittwoch.
Asher Mittwoch. It's
yes.
This is the.
No, this is the end. Normally, no, nothing is going on there.
Okay.
The main party days are the Thursday on Altweiber, which is ridiculously.
What happens there?
Yeah, you drink a lot, you start in the morning, you have a party all night long, all day long. And Friday is more the day where you have a little break. Well, people who go on and exaggerate that a bit.
He's not agreeing. However, just to, because I actually don't know anything about it, how do you compare the German carnival with the Brazilian carnival? Because the Brazilian carnival is well known around the world, and by the way, the Portuguese person or Brazilian person that was supposed to come did not come. Obviously, we don't like the country well enough. So, have you guys ever experienced, or are you interested in experiencing the Brazilian carnival?
Of course I am.
Yeah, of course. There you go.
I'm a cow, man. Okay, sorry.
Yeah, man. I think that deserves a coin, just saying, man.
I don't have.
Well, tough luck, man.
Okay. Next time. Also, you said, so, what are you like? There is also like cars, people dressed up. Are they walking around the street with a huge group of people with drums and music, or is it like real in that way? I mean, carnival is all over the world, but
yeah, it's not as much as real in that case, because I mean we don't have that beautiful girls dancing there. For example, we make more fun of politics and politicians.
No. Well, there you go. That's very interesting.
That's the thing, and people are standing there watching that. So some people don't. They're just partying there. But yeah, that's what it's all about. This is what we do in the daytime.
Is that true? So is that true?
Well, I think Brazil is more about looking
with 10
good.
10 seconds.
But
okay, we have 10 seconds left. I would like to know, like, if you wrap it up, how was it with one word?
One word.
Toy.
Exhausting.
Super. Exhausting. Okay,
right.
You heard
right.
It. Fantastic.
Fantastic.
Thank you very much for books. Watching and see you next week.
See you later.
I'm a cow.
That's so weird, man.
Hello.
That's awesome. I love being a cow.
Hello.
Stop it.
What? Stop it.